This is Trevor Sheatz, our YouTube channel manager. He's the one that gives the great titles to each of the videos. Let's see what he calls this one.
Do you think you're a good person, Anna?
Yes.
Do you think you're a good person?
Yes.
All right. How many lies have you told in your entire life?
None.
That's not one of those lies right now, is it?
No.
You sure?
Okay. Sure, because I can't remember it.
Have any of you not told a lie in your whole life? Any of you? Anybody not told a lie in their whole life? Anna?
Sure.
Anna? I think you may have forgotten those lies that you've told.
Have you ever taken something that wasn't yours? You have. All right, what do you call someone who takes something that isn't theirs? A thief. So what would that make you?
Have you ever taken something that wasn't yours?
No.
No. Ever downloaded music illegally off the internet?
No.
No. Ever took an 11-minute break when you're supposed to take a 10-minute break?
I never take a break.
You never take a break?
Oh,
that's great. I have a lot of nice friends, Anna. That's great. Have you ever used God's name in vain? Like OMG.
That's oh my gosh.
Yeah, like oh my G-O-D. You ever said that in your whole life?
Oh my gosh. OMG is oh my gosh.
Okay, so you never said oh my G-O-D.
No.
Okay, you're doing good so far.
Okay.
Have you ever looked at a guy with lust? I think her response gives the answer to that question.
Jesus said whoever looks at another person to lust after them has committed adultery with them in their heart. You ever looked at a guy with lust?
Okay, yes.
You have? Okay, yes. She did one. All right, so Jesus said that would make you an adulterer at heart. Would you be innocent or guilty of breaking the commandments that God has given you?
I would be guilty of adultery.
That's right up here.
Repent.
If you ask for me, okay, so you're in the court.
That's right.
And the judge says, you're a murderer. What do you have to say to defend yourself? And you go, well, judge, I'm sorry. Please forgive me. I shouldn't have done that, and I'll never do that again.
Studying to show thy own self approved.
Right, so you want me to finish
that? Let's cut it off. Let's not use words that are for you to condemn people.
No, I definitely am not here to condemn anybody.
That are true of the Bible. I love you, darling. I love you, and I love
that
the way
a lot.
You got
don't
away.
Walk away, Anna. Don't do
good.
It.
I gotta go.
No, you don't have to go. God bless you, Anna.
According to Jesus, you would be an adulterer at heart. So I'm not judging you, but just from what you told me you're a lying, thieving, blasphemous adulterer at heart.
Oh my gosh. Okay.
But you also told me you're a good person. Would you be innocent or guilty of breaking his commands? Because that's what I did. I took you through the Ten Commandments. I took you through four of them. Would you be innocent or guilty of breaking God's commands? Based on God's commands, you'd be guilty. Heaven or hell? Lying, thieving, blasphemous, adulterer at heart? Hoping you could. Okay, let's see. Imagine like you committed murder, you were in a court, and the judge says, Amira, you've committed murder. What do you have to say for yourself? No, judge, you're a forgiving judge. No, you're forgiveness, right? That's not how it works. If he's a just judge, he must punish sin, right? Hitler is not going to be forgiven. He's going to receive the punishment he deserves. So God's just, he must punish you, so he would send you to hell. Now let me ask you, Amira, does that concern you that if God were to judge you, he would send you to hell? Okay, it concerns me too, and I appreciate that. I appreciate your honesty with me, and I appreciate you sticking around. Here's the whole point of what I'm trying to say, and then I'll let you go. You've been laughing a lot nervously. I know it's tough being up here. The Bible says that 2,000 years ago, God sent his son Jesus into the world. Jesus was fully God and fully man. He lived a perfect life. He never sinned. And at the end of his life, he was put to death on a cross for your sins. Here's what that means. Take it back to the court. If you committed murder and the sentence was 40 years, but someone comes up and pays your bail, you can now be set free. You can be let go for the crimes you've committed because someone paid the fine. Jesus Christ on the cross paid the fine for the sins of those who would trust in him. So on that cross, he died on the cross and he rose from the grave. And the Bible says this in there, that if you repent of your sins, say, God, I'm sorry, forgive me for my adultery, my lying, my thieving, disrespecting my parents, forgive me of all those things. I believe that Jesus died on the cross for my sins. I believe he rose from the grave and he's the only way I can be saved. Then the Bible promises that he will change your heart. God will take your heart, make you a new creation, save you from the damnation of hell.
The video will continue in a few seconds, but I wanted to remind you to please subscribe to our channel and click on the notifications bell. And don't forget to like, comment, and share. Thank you.
And grant you everlasting life. That's the message we're here to share. So does all that make sense, Amira? All right. Okay, well then let me say this. If you've done that, you might need to pull up your tighten your straps a little bit. Here's what I mean by that. If you're about to go parachuting, you're about to jump out of the plane, and I was like, Amira, your straps are loose. You wouldn't jump, would you? You'd want to tighten those. Make sure they're nice and tight. I want to make sure those straps are nice and tight for you. Because you said you're a good person, that brings up some warning signs in my mind, and here's why. Mark chapter 10, verse 17 and 18, Jesus said there is no one good but God. So who's lying, you or Jesus? It would be you. So that there is no good person. We're saved by grace alone. I am, oh no, we're almost done, Amira. You're holding in there just fine. What God has done is he's offered his grace and mercy. So in spite of our sin, we can be saved. Hey, and even though you weren't a good person, I want to give you $5 just for coming up here. There you go. You did a great job. Of course. Thank you. Thank you all for listening.